Meat bicycle.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of The Hunt here on Borderlands 2 today. Returning, we are on episode 20, I believe, and we're actually going to be farming the badass creeper today for the longbow. That's where we're starting out. I've decided I want a legendary and a unique though, so if we can get the blockhead and the longbow, I'll be really happy about that. I've kind of gone the wrong way actually. I should have really gone the other way through the little hut. I think that's a lot quicker than this way, but hey, we'll see how it goes. Then again, I probably can't gunzerk through that. We'll see. We'll do a run. See how far, see how long it takes us. And while we're waiting for our... Yeah, we've got to wait for our gunzerk to come back, but that'll come back probably just as we get there, which will be good. So yeah, we're going for the, I think it's called the blockhead, isn't it? Let's have a look. Badass creepers. Yeah, blockhead. It's the very first one on the list. I don't know why that took me so long to find, actually. So yeah, we're going to go for that. We're going to go for the longbow, and that'll be today's legendary and unique item to cross off the list. And then probably have to go back to the beatdown, do some beatdown farming. I think the next episode we'll stay in Borderlands 2 and we'll go for some DLC uniques, and we'll pass on the cobra farming. It's nice to have a little break now and again from cobra farming, because it is a long process and you guys don't have to see it every episode, but then again, when we're not in Borderlands 2, we don't go cobra farming, so we do have a bit of a break from it now and again. Oh my god, you're close. You're a sneaky one. You're a very sneaky one, aren't you? Right, is this the badass next? One more? Oh, let's reload. Where's the badass going to go? Always there. Do I need to gunzerk for you? No, I don't. Boom! Absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing in the first run. That's fine. We have to come back here a few times, I think. Oh, can you imagine if we can get the cobra? I say that every single episode, but I am really, really, really hoping we can do it. We can do it, guys. We can do it. Episode 20, that'll be a nice start. Well, sorry, start. That'll be a nice point to get it on. Well, let's see if my theory's correct. Let's go the other way and see if we can make it quicker. It's a bit of a long run getting through here, but once we're out, it should be pretty damn quick. As soon as we get out of this door, start gunzerking, and we should be able to make it there quicker than going round the long way. Should really time this, actually. Should have timed the first run and this second run. I'm pretty sure this is much, much quicker. Yes, it definitely looks a hell of a lot quicker. And we've still got gunzerk at the end, so yes. Look at that. Skills. Right, let's get the dirt out. Why did I come up then? Right, looks like we'll be going that way this time then. Here we go then, creeper time. Drop me the longbow first, actually. I'd rather get that before the blockhead. Don't let them sneak up on you. I think it is just the badass creeper that drops the blockhead and the longbow, but we'll see. Oh, that guy tanked that shot. Whoa. Well, there's a chrysalis behind me. I thought there was a creeper or something sneaking up on me. Those sneaky creepers. Nothing again? Nope, okay. Fair enough. I want to see an iridium block in this episode as well. I like the look of the iridium blocks. They look awesome. I know they've got the gold and the coal, but the iridium blocks look awesome in that purple colour. Okay. Next run then. Let's hope this won't take us too long as well in this episode. If we can get both drops in 20 minutes, I'll be happy with that. But it could take hours, you know that for a fact, guys, watching legendary runs and things like that. But we'll go for about 20 minutes, and if we don't get it, we'll head on out to the beatdown. Then again, if we don't get anything in 20 minutes, I'm going to have to think very, very fast and go and get you something, because I want to tick one thing off the list every episode. That is my goal at the minute. There should be some pretty easy things to tick off. I'll just have to go unique farming. Gone the wrong way. I was looking at my list then. Let's skip right across here. Oh, that was risky, but well worth it. Right, back into the fold then. Come on, let's break the stone. And straight on him. Go away. Go away. We're not messing about this time. Well, until the badass creeper comes out. Oh, that was a bad shot. 2-1? Yes. Go aim for them feet. There's the big boy. Oh, down he goes. Green spinny gun. Green spinny gun is not what I want to see. Three runs in 7 minutes though is not bad at all. Seems to be a long farm, but it really isn't that long when you've got a rocket jumping set up and you can get there quite quickly. If I was farming this without rocket jumping though, it would definitely be a lot longer. And probably not while we're doing this series, but it'd be nice if they do another hunt event that I could take part in. I could probably stream it with that, because they do the hunts on the forums, and obviously with this series I'm actually trying to span it out a little bit, so we get one or two things an episode. Maybe three sometimes if we're lucky, and then off we go. But I'd love to actually take part in the, because I did do the last couple. Well, I tried to hunt four, but I didn't do it very quickly. I'd love to do an actual hunt event where we can get a list and we can just go absolutely crazy, and I mean like just go mad and try and get everything in one episode. So I'd go for like the uniques first. I'd just absolutely rip through the uniques, try and get as many legendaries as we can. Your aim is to just get everything on the list as quickly as possible. Now this series isn't about speed, it's not about getting things as quickly as possible, it's just about finding everything. But I'd love to do an actual hunt. In fact, I've just seen the iridium block. In fact, we might do that when this series ends. And I suppose we'll give it a little bit of a break, because if not it'll be boring. But at some point, I might do a speed hunt where we just go and find everything. That's going to hurt me, not too bad. Because the first thing I'd do in the hunt is do about 15 runs of the armory. That'll be a lot of weapons ticked off the list, definitely. A lot. And then, yeah, you just come to like Borderlands 2 and just get the Bone Shredder, farm the four assassins for the Commerce, the Fremington's Edge, the Judge, and the. What was the other one? I can't remember the other one now. Whatever. And then yeah, you'd go to Captain Flint, get the tinderbox quickly, go to the DLCs, get like the 12 pounder, the damn cowboy, all sorts of things like that. Pre-sequel as well, get all them uniques, they can be got really quickly in the pre-sequel. I suppose in the pre-sequel as well, you could really abuse the grinder to get a lot of the legendaries. Don't know if that's in the rules though. Oh no, it's not in the rules, you're not allowed to use the grinder in the hunt, I don't think. But still, I mean, in Borderlands pre-sequel, you can bend a farm, I think, that's part of the rules, and you know as well as I do, you can do 10 minutes of checking the vending machines and get a legendary every single time. Little tricks as well, like, I'm sure you can get them from any loot source, you don't have to go for the actual the farm, but there's that chest in Heroes Pass, right before you go through to the Vault of the Warrior. You can speed farm the crap out of that, and I have had pearls, I've had legendaries from that chest, loads. But even the farming itself, it'd just be nice to just go as fast as possible and get as many things as possible. So I'm quite looking forward to that. Another, I'll give it a couple of months, like maybe when the announcement of Borderlands 3 comes out, someone will get on the forum and just say, right, are we going to do one final hunt then before a pre-sequel comes out? And I would definitely be taking part in that. Definitely. Well, I can get a 2-in-1 for you guys. If you're going to try ganging up on me. Right, where's the badass coming out? There he is. Come on. Drop us something good. No. Nothing. Being a bit of a stinge bag this time, ain't ya? Being a bit of a stinge bag. But yeah, I think that'll definitely be what someone does. There haven't been a hunt in a while, actually. It's been at least 7 or 8 months, I think, before that, since the last hunt, which I believe was hunt 4. In fact, it probably was even over a year ago, actually, because I'm sure it came out not long after the pre-sequel came out. That's why it came out, because of the pre-sequel, because I remember there wasn't much on the pre-sequel list because obviously you couldn't get them from farmable sources, so that list was really short. But that's what I actually based the list on that I've got at the minute. I added quite a lot to it, updated the pre-sequel obviously because we've had patches since then which allows bosses to farm, bosses to respawn, so you can farm them. But yeah, this list that you see at the end of every episode is basically a Hunt 4 list with my additions and updates too. But yeah, that must have been ages ago because I remember on that list it said things that haven't been on for a while. So that must have been just after the pre-sequel came out, which was, what, nearly 18 months ago now. So we're well overdue for a new Hunt series, but a lot of people don't like the pre-sequel. I was going to say, let me in. Right. Let's punch it. Here we are then. Creeper number one. Can do this a lot quicker now. Creeper number two. That. There we go, don't want to get this badass creeping up on us. Right, is it this time? No. There we go. Boom, down he goes. Hey, there's the colour we want to see. Beautiful, beautiful Omnicannon. Hello, my friend. Omnicannon, oh my god. What? Are you? You're about 3 episodes back, Messiah. Longbow, I mean. There you go. The Minecraft longbow. Beautiful. Oh, look at that colour. It's just glorious. Glorious. So yeah, let's add that to the list in 3, 2, 1. Bing! There we go. The joys of editing. I hope I edited that well enough so that happened. But we are not just here for a longbow, guys, but that has been ticked off the list. Now, I did say I'd be happy if the longbow dropped first, but we do still need that blockhead, so let's go for that. And I've just seen something on the list that's annoyed me a little bit, because I think we found 2 tubbies in this series at the minute, And I've just realised the tubbies drop a unique. Now, the only thing I've looked for when I've killed the tubbies so far are legendary class mods or pearls. But I haven't checked all the other loot, and they do drop the cracked sash, which is a unique red text weapon. So, hopefully, in fact, I might actually go back and watch me getting those tubbies. I know one was in the dust very early on, and one was a couple of episodes ago when we was in the Wildlife Exploitation Reserve farming for the Deliverance, and yeah, farming Perone and Tumba anyway. But I didn't check for the cracked sash, and I forgot about that, so I'm pretty annoyed at myself for that. But hopefully, if I go back and watch them, they won't be there. In fact, I might not go back and watch them, because if they are there, I'm going to be annoyed. But yeah, tubby farming is something that we're going to need to do soon as well. I think the best place to do that is actually Hallowed Hollow, because, get your Norfleets ready, because it's always dark there, and tubbies spawn better in the dark. Right, we're not concentrating on creepers very well here. There we go. So yeah, I might actually go there. In fact, if we can get this blockhead drop quickly, I might do a very quick run of Hallowed Hollow and see if we can get any tubbies to spawn. That could be a good idea. Here he is then. This time, come on, let's have a double drop. If you drop the longbow again, I'm going to be annoyed. I think the blockhead is actually rarer to drop than the longbow as well. I think I've had more longbows than blockheads. Let's not make this too long then. In fact, I might have a quick wander around Hallowed Hollow in this episode instead of going beat down farming, because if we can get some tubbies, yeah, let's scout it out. I think we'll see how long it takes us to get the blockhead anyway, but we'll scout it out like we did in the last episode, sorry, the episode before, where we was in Borderlands 1. We went to the Iridium guards on the way to, you know, the final level before you hit the main unique boss, sorry, vanilla boss. Went to there because I wanted to see if you could get Iridium weapons from the aliens, and you can't really at all. So at least we scouted it out there. We're not asking questions, so I'm going to be doing a bit of investigating in this episode, hopefully. Because if we can find more tubbies over there, obviously tubbies appear everywhere, even in the daylight, but the best chances are at dark. But the trouble is, say like the dust, it's always light there when you quit out and come back in, so you've got to wait around for like 5 minutes for it to get dark, which can be quite annoying and time consuming. Iridium block! Let's break the iridium blocks. I love iridium blocks. Look how nice they look. Wow, it takes so long though. I'll be doing that again. Oh, we've got a blooming gold block next to us as well, and a coal block. Rip. And that creeper's waiting for us. Ha! Left or right? Oh, it's right down there. 1, 2. Got them chrysalis or worm freshers, whatever you want to call them. Just see a red dot behind me. It scares me. You can't actually get him either, I don't think. Here's the badass then. This time, sunshine, blockhead please, so we can go to Hallowed Hollow. No. Okay. Right, 19 minutes in. I said I wouldn't mind this taking 20 minutes, so if we can get it this run, I'll be very happy with that. I should really be farming blue while I'm doing this as well, but like I said, I like the quicker way of going through that building. If I was going the other way, I'd probably call in at blue as well. But we could save blue for another episode. Like I said earlier, this isn't a speed hunt. It's just a chill out, nice couple of episodes where we get one or two items every time and then tick them off the list. Right, here we go then. I'm back, baby! Nice, rocket jumping. Nice, let's get through here. And then two more before we reload. Reload now. And then boost over there. Ah, cliff. Ah, right. Through we go. And creeper time. Iridium block. Was a creeper out after me already? That's gonna blow. Yep. Right, badass. Drop it, bitch. Oh, come on, what is your problem? Where's the blockhead, dudes? Where's the blockhead? Come on, I don't want to have to come back here next episode. Give us that blockhead. I want to do a bit of tubby farming. Tubby time. Probably won't get to do it, but hey. We'll probably go to the 25 minute mark, like I said. Then we'll just have a nice little walk through Hallowed Hollow back area where you don't really need to go after you've defeated the jack-o'-lantern, because there's no farming at all back there apart from tubbies. So hopefully we'll get ourselves one. But the joys of being a rocket jumping gunzerker is I can get there pretty quickly. That's if I've unlocked Hallowed Hollow actually on this character. I should have done. This character's done nearly everything. There's not many missions I've got left to do, in fact, if any. Maybe the arenas. Oh, that fresher popped out quickly. Right, let's reload now. I'm not going to need Gunzerk now anyway. Well, the movement speed's good, but apart from that. Keep breaking that block on top, I don't know why. It's just done it there as well. Oh well. Here we go then. One creeper already. That one's gonna sneak up on me. Nice efficient farming going on here. That badass is going to pop right out on me, isn't he? Yep, there you go. Well, that wasn't very good. He's gone down though. And still no blockhead. Wow, he's really being stingy with this, isn't he? Right, okay. Come on. It's got to be any time now, surely. Gotta be. Huh. Oh, that guy scared me. Didn't expect him to jump out of me that long. That quickly. Keep hitting that ledge by accident. Down we go then. He's actually a really quick farm, this. Thought it was going to take a lot longer. But I think we've done at least 10 or 11 runs of them so far. I think. Probably weren't done. Yours is probably about 7. No, we did 3 runs in the first 7 minutes. So if you take that as an average, that's 9. And then probably 2 more since then. So yeah, it's about 11 runs. At least we got the longbow though, I'm happy at that. I wonder if it's because I'm using these bada booms while it's breaking the top block as well. We'll try it with our fist next time, see if that helps. Not that it makes a massive difference, it really doesn't take that long. Oh! Bonus badass creeper! Didn't drop the blockhead, but sometimes you can get the bonus badass creeper. I should still have a Ballast Creep at the end though. That's good though, that will that's give us an extra chance. Bonus badass it is, nice. Could this be the run then? Why did I reload then? There we go, yes, it was a bonus badass creeper. Drop it. Yes, that's got to be it. It's a shotgun and it's blue. That's got to be it. Yes, there we go. There is the blockhead, guys. The unique red text. Also try Minecraft as a red text. So, once again, 3, 2, 1. Bing! Let's add that to the list. There you go. They are our designated drops of today's episode. I love these blocks. They're so nice. Why don't we add them into Minecraft? I don't know. What could it be? Sapphires, maybe, or something like that? Is that what... No, sapphires are blue, aren't they? What colour gem is purple? I don't know. But anyway, we've got a couple of minutes now to just chill out and go and have a look around Hallowed Hollow. To be fair, I could really farm Clark, the Combusted Crypt Keeper, Combustible Crypt Keeper, whatever his name is, for Pyrophobia at some point, if I don't want to do Incinerator Clayton. But for now, let's go, we'll just go to the top. It's called, what is it called again? Hallowed Hollow. I've said that already. Duh. Right, it should always be dark here. If that works on the mechanics of tubbies, then we should get some tubbies appearing pretty quickly. Let's boost across this bridge. See if we can remember our way. I think it's right up over to that bridge. Yes, this way, and then over here, through the gates. And I want to be heading to the right. No, we've gone the wrong way already. I haven't been here for a long time, so bear with me. Yes, it's up here. Up here it is. Wow, it's been a long time since I came here. Right, this should be the church somewhere. And we need to, yeah, there's the church, I think. Oh no, I'm going the right way. I was meant to go the other way, but this is the way I want to be. So, we've got some spider ants. Tubby spider ants we were all looking for. I think there's another area out of here as well where you can get them. Well, let's not kill them all. Let's just keep an eye out. I've found tubbies here before though, so we'll just shoot them anyway. And if we can find any, I'll be happy. So, I mean, there's loads of them around here, and technically it is dark. Oh, that was not my bada booms. Boost me, bada booms. Again, we might not find anything, but it's probably as pointless doing this as it is cobra farming. Well, there's a red chest here, I suppose, to take on. To open. Any more tubbies? Yes, there's some more up here. There's a slag. Don't slag the slag spider ant. That will not do you any good, Messiah. Right, I think that's it. So it's definitely a good area at the start, but it's worth popping out of the back here. Now, what are these enemies here? Are they just... Yeah, they're skeletons. Okay, well, we can do a couple of runs of that, 2 or 3 runs altogether, I think, and just check. It's worth it, isn't it, really, guys, just to find a tubby. It's definitely worth it. All day long. Because those little gits are very hard to find. And after we get the... after we get the cobra... Can I just boost straight over there? I can't. After we get the cobra, and after we get the hive, my main priority then will be tubby farming. I've gone the wrong way again. I want to be up here. There's the church. I ran straight past it. Right, back again. Can we get one this time? Slave, slave, ow. Monarch. Where's this guy? Ow. Where is he? Oh, he's right up there, look. Spider-Man slaved and slag Spider-Man. Yeah, there's me talking when the... What the hell are you doing up there, dude? Right, more up here. Spiderling. Two spiderlings. See, another one's just spawned. That's why I thought it was good to kill them. Two blazing. See, they are different every time, though, so that does mean our chances of a... See, there's another one here, look. Oh, look, there's loads spawning, see? Should have maybe stuck around a little bit last time. Is that it? I think that's it. Well, definitely worth sticking around next time then. Killing everything before I move on. Right, let's head through the arena. Nice little shortcut there. Let's keep Gunzerk on if we can. Right, what have we got here? Spider-Man Slave. Well, if that was a Tubby, the other one, then it won't have... It won't have been a Tubby, or it wouldn't have just gone down in one shot. Right, don't slag the slag Spider-Man again. Rotting Pumpkin. What are you doing here? Keep your nose out. We're after Spider-Ants, not you guys. Right, let's go and open this chest. And we'll try once more. Probably isn't any better an area than anywhere else, but it's somewhere different. I haven't been here for a long time, so I'm happy to come back and have a little look round. Like I said, if we come back here to do Tubby farming, we can also do try and spawn Clark the Combustible Crypt Keeper in and get the Pyrophobia. Because this isn't the only area spider ants are in, I'm sure it isn't. There's plenty more down at the back of Jack-O-Lantern, I think. But hey, this area is pretty much untouched, so we can definitely come back here. Right, let's go the right way this time. And slam into the gate. Well done. There we go. Now we're on par. Oh, yep. Oh no, that would have been nice if I'd got over there. Right. Spider ants. Where are you? Right. Two slaves. Diseased. And a slave. Right, more up here. There's a slag, a slave. What's this? Another slave. There we go. More spawning. What are you two? Slaves? Yeah, there's a lot of slaves. Is that it? I think that's it. Well, until we get to here. Oh no. See, more do spawn. Whoa, Monarch. About to run out of Gunzerk. Well. I think that's it now. Still no luck. What's that? Oh, supply of candy. I forgot that you dropped the drop candy. I won't mind the speed candy actually right now. I think that's yellow though. Speed candy's good. Speed candy with rocket jumping Gunzerker is even better. Oh, got a bit over quick on that one then. Right, let's open the chest quickly. Nope. Right, give me a Tubby. I'm off straight for this guy actually first. Ow. Maybe shouldn't have gone straight for him. Right, Spider-Man slaves. That's it. Drop some yellow candy. Oh, there is. Right, what's this? Faster! Look at the flight on that. That was ridiculous. Right, guys, what time is it? I may have time for one more run. Very quickly, one more run. Really, really quickly. Because I've got to go out. Right. Let's make this the quickest one yet. I'm just going to run through them all. I'm not even going to wait for the others to spawn. Or am I? I am. Of course I am. Don't want to half measure this. Yeah, quickest one yet. And I get stuck on the first obstacle. And I'm going to get stuck here now. Yep, there you go. Right. Speed it up. Speed it up. Wonder if there's a way to get in the church by rocket jumping. Glitching through a roof or something. I might investigate that. Wow, I did get here very quickly, actually. Right, what we got? Spider-Man slaves. Ow. That one hurt. And I'm down again. Blazing Spider-Man. Yellow candy, yay. Yellow candy. Oh, it's so much quicker. I love yellow candy. Well, let's go and spawn these, and then the guys behind us should come in. Yes. Nicely done. Slave. Spiderling. Slave? Is that it? Yellow candy. Oh, yellow candy's worn off. Oh, might need to reload. And I'm about to run out of guns there. But that was good, we got all that done in one round. I was convinced we'd maybe find a tubby today. That's a shame. Right, last little section then. But yeah, after that I will head on out. But I just want to say thank you for watching, everyone. Did really well in this episode, actually, to get the blockhead and the longbow in one run. And yeah, it's nice just to not have to beat down farm now and again. But next episode we probably will end up beat down farming, because we have to keep on top of it, or it'll just get out of hand. But that looks like it's it for the spider ants. So thank you for watching, everyone. Really hope you enjoyed another episode of The Hunt. That was episode 20. The next episode will be a highlights reel of everything we've done so far, so be sure to look out for that. And yeah, anyway, thank you, and I'll see you guys in the next one.